Hi, I'm Jay Goldman. You are watching Mr. Mobile on Butterscotch.com. Today, a look at Meteor Blitz on the iPhone. I think it's well worth it, but I've always been a big fan of Asteroid-type games. I remember playing Asteroid on my Atari 2600 way back in the day, and I'm also a big fan of the emerging category of games on the iPhone that use the two thumbs on the screen for controls. You may remember way back in episode 38 of Mr. Mobile, we reviewed Minigore, which worked sort of the same way. So this one works on that same principle. It's called Meteor Blitz again. It's by Ali Labs, who are actually based in Vietnam, which is kind of cool. And it combines those two great things together. So it's an asteroid game that uses the two thumbs for control. It's also got a really interesting thing for pausing. If you take your fingers off the screen while you're playing, it pauses. And that seems really obvious, but it's the first game that I've encountered that in, and I have to say it's really, really cool. So, you know, sometimes when I'm on the subway on the way to work, for example, and I'm playing the game, and I get to my stop, I just take my fingers off, walk off. When I get back to, you know, to the next subway or the bus or whatever, I just put my fingers back on and I keep playing and game's, you know, right there. The other nice thing about it is if you switch out of the application, you get a phone call or you just hit your home button or whatever, it just pauses your game exactly where it was and you can come back days later and just pick your game up exactly where you'd left off. So you don't sort of have that, I need to finish this level so I can get to a point where I can save or whatever. You just stop playing. When you come back in, you'll be right where you left off. If you've ever played Super Stardust HD on the PS3 or Geometry Wars on the Xbox, this is going to look pretty similar to those. Same sort of concept. You're flying a little ship around. You got to blow stuff up. There are two modes in here once you hit the play button. So you can choose between arcade and survival mode. Survival, you basically just keep playing until you die. Arcade has six worlds that you need to work your way through. You fly your ship around once you're in the game using the control on the left side here. The other thumb control over here is for the direction that you're firing in. Same sort of concept as Minigore was, if you remember that from episode 38. There are three kinds of asteroids that you need to blast in this game. There's sort of a rock one, there's kind of a fire one, and then there's a nice one. There are also three kinds of shots that your ship can shoot, and they're matched to the asteroid. So if you pick the right shot, it destroys them faster. With fire, you use the ice shot. With ice, you use the fire shot. With rock, you use the green shot. I don't know what the green shot is, but it works pretty well when you're shooting on rocks. Just above the firing control on this side, there's actually a button that lets you tap. You tap on that to switch between the different kinds of shots. So there's those three, tapping on them once to cycle through. And just below the fire control is the bomb detonator. That destroys everything that's visible on the screen right now, except for the boss, and it will sort of do a bunch of damage to him. So you can use a bunch of bombs to get rid of him. You pick up bombs as you go through, and you also use them up every time you tap the button. So that's kind of a limited resource. You can also shake the phone to trigger the bomb. You can turn that off if you find it annoying. I thought it was kind of a novelty at first and then pretty quickly switched to tapping because while you're playing the game and trying to shake it at the same time, it's a little bit tricky. As you're flying around and blowing up these asteroids, they kind of spit out rings as they're dying. It feels a little bit Super Mario Brothers almost. And you need to pick up those rings as you're playing through the level because at the end of every level, you can upgrade your ship with different weapons and sort of speed boosts and stuff like that, depending on the number of rings that you bought. So it's almost like a store where you trade them in. You'll also get bonuses as you're playing, and you need to blow up the bonus to pick it up. It'll turn into one of a bunch of different things, and then you can just run over it with your ship to pick it up. So you can get things like an extra life. There's a slow bonus, which slows down everything on the screen, lets you shoot your enemies and blow up some rockets, slows down everything except for you, of course. And then there are bombs. And the best bonus, I think, is rings, which actually makes all of the rings from everything you blow up come and find your ship for you. So you don't have to go around and pick them up. If you run over the rings bonus, they'll just all come to you and you can just go around blasting stuff for the rest of the level. Every level ends in a boss who's surrounded by a bunch of metal spheres. He doesn't actually shoot at you. On the first level of each, on the first round of each level, I guess, the boss just kind of floats around. But after that, he starts shooting the spheres out at you, which can get a little bit tricky. And basically, you blow up the boss to finish the level. There's not much info in the iTunes Store about what's different in the free version. Presumably, it has fewer levels than in the Pro version. I would recommend just going up straight to the Pro version because if you like Asteroid games and you like playing games on your iPhone, this has got to be one of the better ones that are out there. But, of course, you can always grab the free version if you'd like. It is one of the nicer games that do honor sort of the audio that you're playing. So if you're listening to your own music, you can continue to do that. If you're not, it has its own music inside of the game. It's kind of fun to fly around blowing stuff up to your favorite songs, but it's got a pretty decent soundtrack. Graphics are really high quality. I would say it's definitely worth $2.99 if you're a fan of the genre. Go check it out. I'm Jay Goldman. This has been Mr. Mobile. Thanks for watching. You can check us out on butterscotch.com.